Oh, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome once again to Theater Breaking Through Barriers, third Virtual Playmakers Intensive, or VPI3 Inunion. Oh my goodness, happy Saturday night, everyone. I have to say, this has been an incredible week. In spite of all the craziness that is going on in the world outside, in spite of all the tension and the divisiveness and all of the events that have happened, the bombardment with the news and all that, now we are able to take a little bit of time to just clear all that away and enjoy each other's company and enjoy this little bit of a respite. This week has been really, again, we started our third Virtual Playmakers Intensive on Monday. And every night we have just been getting, like, it's like a great fireworks display, one after another, just a constant barrage of really beautiful work by really, really incredible artists. And I will say to you that tonight, Saturday night, is absolutely no exception. So I cannot wait for you to see the work that we're going to present to you tonight. I am going to tell you once again that after this show, we're going to do a little bit of a talk back with our incredible playwright, our wonderful director, and the stellar cast that you're going to be seeing. So if you have any thoughts or questions about the work that we're doing, just type it into the YouTube feed, and my incredible tech guru, who is also my co-host, Tucker Salavara. Tucker, there he is. Hey, Tucker, happy Saturday. How are you?
Good. How are you, Nick?
You know what? I am great. We really got through an incredible week, and I'm seeing all positive here.
Yeah.
So again, I want to thank you for all of your work, because we could not do any of this without you. Your technical prowess, your ability to link and connect everything together. We have live stream captioning going on tonight, and it's all, you know, you coordinated all of that. And you're going to be watching the stream. So if anyone has questions, just write them in. Tucker will then pop on at the end of the show, and we'll be able to ask these questions of our artists. So I hope that you will do that. So Tucker, thank you again for everything.
No problem. Happy to help.
You're a big part of it, so thanks. So tonight, I have to say, this playwright is, I know we use the word genius a lot, but I have to say, I would love to be able to crawl inside their mind. And because I mentioned that to Nico earlier, that you know, the things that they think of and the wonderful creative, you know, sparks that are just flying all over the place, to be able to create a show like the one you're about to see is truly remarkable. So I just wanted to say that. The play was written by Nico Grelli, and it is directed by a phenomenal director and writer, and, you know, and just an incredible artist, Shellen Lubin. This is the first time that she's working with us, so I'm just, again, very honored and thrilled that she's here. And the play features three remarkable stars, three remarkable artists: Richard Lear, Martin Lewis, and one of my oldest and dearest friends, Richard M. Rose. So, ladies and gentlemen, all of you out there in YouTube land, please sit back, relax on this gorgeous Saturday night, and enjoy, take in Nico Grelli's There Are Too Many of Us, Government TV's most popular mandatory game show. Enjoy.
Cats in, chickens in, cats. How now, brown cow? Wearing too many hats. Which way? Which way? Over there. Okay. Hello, world. Greetings, terrestrial onlookers. Salutations, earthlings. Nope. scale it down, keep it in your hometown, keep it low down. First impressions are everything. They make their minds up the moment you enter. Go. What's up, global citizens? Human populace? Mortal meatbags of all shapes and proportions? Nope, nope, nope. What did I tell you? This is your life on the line. Take a breath. Take a pill. Be chill. Go. What's up? Samuel here. How they hanging? And by they, I'm referring to your sweet little feelings, not your sweet little bits that may or may not dangle. It's really a metaphorical genitalia to which I'm referring, but oh my God, Samuel. Shut up, shut up. Start over, you tangential cunt. Don't you cry now. Look at me. Suck it up. You swallow it down. You show them your crown. Walk out like you own the town. How's everybody doing tonight? My name is... God damn it, what's my... Oh, starts with... Oh, Samuel Jesus Henry fuck me Christ! Hi, I'm Samuel. Smile. That's it. Simple. Breathe. Tonight, I am singing one of my most favorite songs, and I sure hope it's one of your favorites as well. Don't sound desperate now. Tonight, I will be singing one of my favorite tunes, Dropkick Me Jesus Through the Goalpost of Life. And if it ain't one of your favorites, by golly, I got a feeling that once these sweet lips give it a whistle, it will be. That's how you do it now. Mama might have wanted a couch more than she wanted a baby, but you're here to prove you're worth more than the sum of being sat upon. Or by God, your name ain't...
Daniel!
Yes? Yes?
You're up in
2 minutes? Oh, Lord, I haven't even had a chance to go through my song. Do I look all right? You would tell me if I didn't, I trust. Is this well lit enough for the judges to... Should I go pee?
Be ready to go. It's 90 seconds from now.
Can I ask... Is it immediate for the loser when they decide? When you watch it on TV, it seems so sudden. But then I realize it's TV. And they can edit things and play with time and such.
Are you in an apartment or a house?
House.
It's pretty immediate. Apartment buildings slow them down. Lack of windows, narrow hallways, staircases and whatnot. Houses have more points of entry. It's 1 minute.
Wish me luck.
There's no such thing. 30 seconds. Be ready for me to count you in.
Take a breath. Take a pill. Chill. Take a breath. Take a pill. Chill. Take a breath. Take a pill.
Samuel, you are going live in 5, 4, 3. Simon. You're up after Samuel. His song goes about 3.5 minutes. He will receive his feedback. He will receive more feedback from the judges. We cut to commercial and then... Simon, are you listening?
Not so sure.
Me?
What does it matter even, trying?
Did you hear me say that Samuel's song is about 3.5 minutes?
Hey, you don't mind working for this enterprise?
Well, it keeps me out of the lottery.
Time is the most valuable currency ever invented by mankind.
I recommend you use the restroom. Warm up if you need to. I'll leave you be until we're 1 minute out.
What if I forfeit?
I believe it forfeits the other contestant as well.
And we both... That's so fucked up.
I'll leave you be.
Ubi caritas et amor Deus ibi est.
Simon, this is your 1 minute.
Thank you. 1 minute.
Simon, you are on 5, 4, 3.
Six minutes later.
I feel good. Mm-hmm. I gave it. I couldn't have gave it better. Even if I could have. Do you feel good about what you did out there? Confident, ain't we? All righty then, I'm all for it. Confidence, part of this balanced breakfast, I like to say. What song did you sing?
Well, I had a song prepared, a song I sing most days just to myself. But when it came time, I changed my mind and I did something else.
Well, don't keep me in suspense.
I performed It's a Hard Knock Life from Annie with as much of the original choreography I could remember.
Honey, that's a group number. Whose part you sing?
All of them. As many as I could remember, at least.
With accompaniment?
A cappella.
Lord of mercy. I'm sure it was memorable.
It was terrible.
Okay.
I had a blast. I hope you had fun too.
Honey, I was fighting for my life out there. Huh. Well, I suppose a thanks is in order.
For what?
For throwing in the towel.
We're all getting the thing we want. No losers here.
Huh. Well then, cheers to us both, you strange little man. Is it time?
Here's how it goes, gentlemen. The judges would like to thank you for being participants on There Are Too Many of Us, Government TV's most popular mandatory game show. The president would like to thank you for doing your duty as citizens and fulfilling your obligation to appear on the show when your names were drafted at random. The decision will be told to you both by the judges, but you will already know their choice when we are back on air. In a moment, I will transmit a waiver to the loser to sign with their thumbprint, allowing for their immediate termination to be viewed live on air upon announcement by the judges. The loser is asked to appear surprised at the decision when announced. I have sent you a spreadsheet with different appearances of surprise that you can choose from in case you need inspiration. In signing, the loser is also committing to a show of resistance to whatever method of extermination has been chosen. I will also include a spreadsheet highlighting resistance options should you need the inspiration. Acquiescence will be met with prolonged extermination, which is not advised. Any questions?
Yeah. What the H-E double hockey sticks does that all fucking mean?
I think it means you got to fight back some or they'll torture you. Good TV needs conflict. Can't have you lying down like a limp French fry.
Who you telling, friend? I ain't got to do nothing. Lay it on us. I'm ready for my 5 years of guaranteed lottery exemption.
Transmitting. Samuel.
Yes. Is this a joke?
I'll need your left thumbprint.
Wait.
I asked you, is this a joke? Because I ain't laughing.
No joke.
There has got to be a mistake. The judges gushed about my performance. Said it praised our Lord Almighty with an elevated reverence near to godliness, and that it was gonna be impossible to top. And you're telling me this grinning dipshit does a one-man show of Annie, and now it's lights out for me? I demand a recount.
He's right. It should be me.
You're both back in 1 minute. Samuel, I'm gonna need that thumbprint.
And if and I don't?
The waiver is only an agreement to having it happen on camera. You are inherently obligated to the consequences of losing this contest by being a citizen of this country. I advise you to take this anger and let it inform the way that you resist your extermination. You will have free rein to express your want to live until you are no longer alive.
I'm so sorry, Samuel.
I tried so hard, and now I'm just good as dead. How is that fair? How is any of this fair?
Start by admitting, from cradle to tomb, it isn't that long to stay. Life is a cabaret, old chum. Come to the cabaret.
I don't know what to make of you.
All right, gentlemen. You're going live in 5, 4, 3.
Well done, Samson. You're showing great skill in handling the unpredictabilities of human emotion. It is not in our nature to lie, but you use this trait of theirs effectively in concealing your identity and in establishing trust with your subjects. And you surprised us with your handling the more difficult of the two. What made you think to use the quote? It was rather intuitive and highly effective.
Humans are very tied to their misconceived notions of death, which is why we must make them face it in order to receive our guidance. I've learned that it is only in the face of imminent death that most humans learn to exist with themselves at multiple points on their own timelines at once. We have possessed this ability for a millennia, but most of them have not yet transcended to this level of existence, and it threatens their future as a species as well as the planet's resources. I know that it is of utmost importance that the humans are kept unaware and unsuspicious of our involvement and of our purposes, but in order to not raise suspicion, trust must be established. Cabaret was the subject's favorite childhood entertainment before his family deemed it sacrilege and disavowed him from watching. The story explores themes of sexuality and gender that challenge the binary that religious humans tend to cling to. And as a child in a household with street and strict gender norms, it held great resonance to him. I scanned my archives for a line from that play that might be poignant in his moment of crisis and allow him to face his death. And I was lucky in my selection. Allow me to correct myself. There is no such thing as luck. There is only the light. Human habits are quite addictive and largely useless, I find. Once they learn our ways, they will be healed.
We are the light.
The light is the way.